I'm Allendale's chief meteorologist Ryan Martin with a look at your midday weather update. Surface map right now shows a large-scale but dying storm complex still lingering over the upper Midwest. Low pressure has moved right along the border between Minnesota and Iowa. Still has a ways to go to make it into Lake Superior, which I think is where it ends up overnight tonight and into early tomorrow morning. So far, precipitation has been limited to areas north of the occluded front that's rotating through there, but we've actually seen better snows over parts of northern and central Minnesota back into the eastern Dakotas than what we thought we could see. It's been kind of interesting to watch it develop on radar, because the radar still shows things pretty light, not even wondering whether half of it's hitting the ground. And then you get responses from folks up in the area, and it's like, yeah, we got some snow. So this low is going to truck to the northeast, bringing in some cold Canadian air behind it, and we're going to be dealing with that, I think, for a couple of days, and then we're going to see temperatures go back to the mild side, or at least normal to slightly above, as we go on through the end of the weekend and into early next week. What I think we've got going on here as we go through the next week and a half to 2 weeks is a fight between what should be happening and a pesky warmer air mass that just doesn't want to leave. Some models are trying to show a big breakdown in that and a big push of Canadian Arctic air as we go toward the end of next week. Others are saying, no, hold on, hold the phone. I'm going to reserve judgment at this point. I do think we get back into a colder pattern, but to me, it all comes down to a significant system coming out of the southern plains as we head through the later stages of next week, the 10th, the 11th, the 12th. Going to have to watch this closely because I'm seeing a low, Texas, Oklahoma, but the latest European model wants to keep that low south, keeping it down in the deep south and then coming up the Atlantic coast. Meanwhile, other models are trying to move that thing more northeast. I think to me the track is not as important as what the strength of the low is. If we get a good circulation on that system, I think that's what's going to open the door to drawing some cold air in out of Canada. If it doesn't, if it's benign or fizzles out or just does nothing, that probably leaves us in a situation where we aren't going to have much help in getting the cold air down in. So kind of a mixed bag, a mixed reaction here, and we'll just have to see how we go. International weather still looking honestly just fine as far as I'm concerned. A little bit dry over parts of Brazil. We're hearing people talk about that, but generally speaking, they're getting enough rain to this point to keep things going just fine. As a matter of fact, we're hearing complaints even of too much rain down in southern parts of Brazil. Argentina is going to be a little bit drier here over the next 10 days to 2 weeks. Not completely devoid of rain, but the coverage is what I'm looking at here. It's not spectacular. Looking at scattered showers as we finish out this week, going into early next week over most of Australia's wheat belt from Western Australia through South Australia and into New South Wales and Northern Victoria. Coverage there, no better than about 50%. That's what we were talking yesterday. No reason to change our thoughts there. And scattered showers, some snow showers around in the former Soviet Union areas. But the one thing that's interesting there, temperatures back above normal, and they're probably going to stay that way for the next 10 days to 2 weeks. So overall, no real serious news headlines with regard to weather at this point. It's just one of these deals where do we see an active pattern emerge across the U.S. or not? And I guess even if we do, it doesn't really matter that much at this stage of the ballgame. If you've got any questions on the weather, give us a call at Allendale. I'm Chief Meteorologist Ryan Martin.